Dr. K. Keshava Rao.
Good suggestion.
Thank you, sir. The very fact that most of the people, almost all the people, are supporting a bill like this shouldn't require repetition at all. First of all, I would like to congratulate at the very outset my friend, best friend Shiva, for working out the entire bill in its detail. I was just thinking it's some kind of a support that we should give to people whom we have been discriminating for no reason at all. Sir, birth is natural, it is not legal. When I'm born, it's nothing like human rights at all. It's my natural right, I speak. And you bring the natural right, human rights later on. Now, whatever it be, the question today is, only the word hijra, he said, whether it's to be constituted parliamentary or not. They are known by many names. Joktas we call, Koti we call, Shiva Shakti we call. There are many names given to the hijras. But the reality, the reality check tells you they exist and they're part of you. That diverse presence in the present milieu and present society, which my best friend said. Having seen as a reality which you cannot shun, yet what we do is, as Mr. Gill said, somehow we have some kind of aversion or some kind of a distaste attitude towards them. Why is this? Now, I have seen Mr. Shiva's bill in detail, and also everybody. All of us are trying to talk about the facilities to them, rights to them. According to me, the Constitution, if you read it, the rights do exist. They're not being given another matter. The International Convention, 62, the Constitution of India, giving my right to identity, right to my own style and my own life and my own practices. All these are right. Even the laws of the land, even the Supreme Court, and recently Sikri and Radhakrishnan have given you that they should get the full right. But unfortunately, the present government, Mr. Minister, sir, you have challenged the Supreme Court order. Later, the Advocate General said, Attorney General said, no, we have not challenged it, we wanted a clarification. Clarification, no clarification, the man exists. His plight is sad, gory. What we must do is we must react. We must respond. He says the first lady Madhubali is not only Madhubali. Earlier also we had Kali in Madhya Pradesh, another mayor. We have today two or three MLAs. That they're slowly there, but they're not getting as a right, as a part of the social system. That is what Shiva's concern is and what the concern of all of us is. While we exist along with them, yet we think that some kind of sympathy should flow from us towards that section. Sir, I don't want to repeat because many things have said. Mr. Tripathi had brought in all the statistics. These statistics are available, which Shiva also repeated. But let me tell you, it is not only Roma who has said many things that the statistics are not good. Time and again we have been saying the statistics about this transgender are not adequate, are not correct at all. The much more Roma might have said, Nagarajan might have said it. Earlier, Tamil Nadu writers, I think Vadamani and Revati, their books, their novels are translated all over the world. 36 languages. Guru Purana, Mr. Tripathi referred. It has given in detail. All these things are scriptures back it, international law back it, your constitution back it, our own views back it. Yet, this kind of a paradox situation still exists. We must say, somewhere stopped it. Mr. Shiva sir, through you I'll tell you, he has given what exactly they require is all right, as constitutional rights are given. But basically let us understand why this mind had come. Why this reservation in us? It could be their behavioral pattern. It could be their body language. It could be our own innate feeling of hatred towards something which is not you. As you say, outcast, even outcast also we are trying to like them. So what is required is, as he said, genetic studies, biogenetic studies, genome studies, presentations tell you there can be correction method. It is not only reassignment surgeries that are going to correct it. A man can be what he is. A lady can be what he is. A transgender could be what he is. But yet, if it is only behavioral pattern, there are psychological studies, psychological texts, which can be brought in. I rather request the government, please look into this. Let us have this kind of a motivational courses which correct the man's body behavior and also his own attitude towards the other man. This is the basic thing, because sir, I have an experience of myself being a minister, then when people are not allowing a transgender to take admission in school, we thought we would have a separate seat for him. We said no, we'll have it. Then we had separate classes for motivational classes, that is called. So this kind of a thing should be at one. I have seen the bill, that is not there. I think the mover of the bill, Mr. Shiva, must also look into the particular issue wherein he has said about physical corrections, reassignment and medical things and toilets and all things are there which the minister has seen. I don't want to repeat because all of us said. First of all, let us see. First of all, let us all help to bring them out of their trauma. Let us all go with responsiveness and own them as part of this society, if not part of you. So first it must come in us. What exactly can be done through the law or the social awareness is first thing that we must do. Number two, some kind of a motivational classes for them where they accept us as equals instead of saying that they are not part of us, are not equals to us. That should go to them and no should go to us. Then come the things which Shiva has given in the 13th thing, educational reservations or the separate in the medical, in the hospitals, separate treatments or the toilets, all these things are there. So I don't want to repeat what is it. The bill is so comprehensive. When we are looking into it, it has comprehended the problem and brought in a comprehensive fashion all those things. The two or three things, as I said, there's an expert committee which has looked into it. I know the commission. And I also congratulate Tamil Nadu, which has, it is not for even evident. It is Ramaswamy Nayakar who had wrote in one of his writings about this gender and how it should be brought in and made a part of the society. So today, Tamil Nadu government, earlier, much earlier. Now I believe when the honorable member was talking about the pensions being given, this is what exactly we should do. It is not the 1,000 rupees that we are giving. It is only saying we own you. You are part of you. This then, West Bengal has also started a welfare board. We have not heard much except the plan they have given, action plan. They are looking to the welfare aspect of it, like amenities, the hospitals. This is not that. First, so they make them the part of a milieu, make them totally that kind of awareness that must come in you and come in them. We need some kind of a correctional studies which focus on the correctional methods, behavioral patterns, then come to physical things. Because, sir, the worst discriminated blocks today, as Mr. Tripathi has rightly said, there are two. One is these Kotis, whom you call Idras or Shiv Shakti, whoever it is. Number two is physically and mentally challenged, this challenge. These two, but they exist. Let us not show sympathy at all. Let us own them. It is not our owning them. Let the society own them. And let society look to you and to them equally. This, I think, the very spirit of the bill is that. And since all of us have lent support to it, as my friend Pascal said, if the bill can't become an act because it has come from the private people. It cannot be that kind of a... it can come. Whatever it is, I want the government, even if you are...
Has been passed in the House and have become.
Yeah. So, even otherwise, while that I would rather go that route, even second route is let the minister, let the government know. Since all the people are agreeing with this, every part of what is said in the bill and extra, please bring it in. Lastly, I would like to say there is, as far as the BJP is concerned, or the NDA government, as I see, because you are replied to Supreme Court. You are unnecessarily mixing up with 377. 377 is a practice. Transgender is a nature. I am born that way. Let me live and let me correct or let me live as I want it. That you cannot change. 377, which you are talking about gays or homosexuals, is entirely about a practice you thought. Unnatural sex. Mixing these two in the Supreme Court when we have argued, has brought in all this problem. What is Mr. Shiva, I have discussed this with Shiva also. What the bill said, it did not mix up that at all. It talked about a particular sect, which Mr. Bhaskar has very well said. It is not only this, not Guru Purana, we said, or this or that scripture said about the biogenetic formations, these things. Sir, let this thing, let them come, let them get all their rights, let them be part of the society which they do belong. There are, I would rather congratulate this government also. We have elected members, we have MLAs, we have mayors. They are asserting themselves. They have their Kalyana Sangam, which fighting for them. And we are also fighting for the very fact that we are talking this way, in this fashion. So loudly shows that we all agree with that kind of a movement. But let us give some kind of a constitutional thing, because by birth, I have that my natural right. By birth, I have got that right. Though you need not give me through your acts or human rights. You give us, but in what fashion you would like to integrate them in this present society, which is totally prone to discriminate each other, a caste-ridden society. Let this not become a part of the caste, let become part of the humanism. And I request the minister, on behalf of all the people said, is not on my behalf, that since all of us are agreeing to it, look into it, if as it is, you can accept it, because we are insisting, at least I would like to insist this to be passed. Otherwise also, if you are thinking, if you can give assurance, please make an expert committee, a commission, which studies it, with this, the base being the present bill. If we are also coming out with something wherein we have all the rights given, but at making them part of the society without our saying as if we have done anything, for them to say that they have a right, they are part of this society and part of this constitution, that is what we are seeking, and I hope the government would look into this.
Thank you. Dr. E.M. Sudarsana Natchiappan.
Vice Chairman, sir, I support this bill moved by our Honorable Member, Mr. Tirichi Shiva, for the protection of the rights of the transgender persons, which is a well-structured bill. I hope he has done, as other members of the parliament has told, the job of the government to draft the bill is already done by the Honorable Member, Mr. Shiva. I feel that the Honorable Minister is also a very nice gentleman, we know it. He has to take it as a historical event to accept this bill as government bill. If you feel that you cannot accept it immediately, at least you should give an assurance that after a period of at least the second part of the budget session, it should be taken up as a government bill. Why we are stressing this particular point is, many of the members of the parliament are working and doing a lot of research to come forward with a piece of legislation. We are not following the model of the United States parliament. That the parliament members are bringing a lot of bills which were accepted by the constitution, according to the constitution. The members' names were also mentioned as the bill is moved by so-and-so. The president of the United States accept it. In certain cases only, if it is not favorable to their own strategy, then they may not accept it. Otherwise, that bill is also made as one of the bill which is binding upon the government. Therefore, this structure is also taken into consideration when our constitution has been drafted. And this part of the hour, which is allotted for 2.5 hours for the private members, is a special thing for bringing the members' contribution. If when they are sitting in the opposition or in the ruling bench, their own individual recognition is brought up by this method of private member resolution or private member bills. But this particular bill is on the basis of a international convention. It is based upon the United Nations. Many of the organizations have come forward that every domestic law should have this protection to the transgender. We were having it as a conventional method. You know very well that even the Mughals period and also subsequently also, these people were used for the protection of the princes and the ladies of the kingdom. Because they were very bold enough, they are very sincere, they are very loyal to the kingdom. Therefore, they were protecting the lady folks of the kingdom. Subsequently, they were treated excellently by their own identity. But after a certain time, they become one of the stigma of the society. They feel that they are isolated. They are indicated by others as a mockery. They want to show their identity by way of using the different type of dress, using their body behavior, using the tone for certain purposes, and further, they started to be abused by the society also. That is why the Parliamentarian Forum on Human Rights and also the Parliamentarian Forum on HIV/AIDS has taken up this issue, and the United Nations Development Organization is also taking up a special case of study, because I could attend that conference in Bangkok in 2010, where the Asian people are very much affected by this transgender stigma. The European countries and American countries, they could come forward with the protection on the basis of the European constitution, and also the European courts are also protecting them. They got equal rights in everywhere. They were identified as a third gender. They were having their own dignity. They are protected by health-wise. Their operation, that is the surgery method, is also accepted. The procedure is accepted by the European countries. The America is also accepting it. The Canada is also accepting it. And also the Argentina and many other countries in the Southern Africa, America, they are accepting it. The Asian countries are also now gradually coming up with the legislation. And we want to create the awareness among the people that this is not the sin of anybody. Our friends were citing many of the Vedic happenings. Shikandi is one of the character who was holding a small kingdom, who was a woman earlier in the birth. At that time, she could not get the marriage with another prince. Therefore, Bhishma at that time was committing some sin. Therefore, he was born as a transgender, being the head of the prince, and he hid himself behind the Arjuna and killed Bhishma. That is the story which we are studying it. This is a sort of showing that the third gender is accepted as the chief of the kingdom. This is the story which gives the braveness of a particular third gender. Similarly, they have got every capacity to do in this world. Therefore, we have to take them as a human being. Whether they are working for the development of the society, whether they have to be brought into the mainstream as a part of the human activities, whether we are giving equal justice in each and every aspect. Now we are citing very boldly that the incident of the winning of the mayor, that was Madhu Bhai Kinna, was the first mayor from the, she was doing dancing in the train, and she was singing in the train, but finally people accepted her as the mayor of a city. These are all historical things happening in India. And the judgment which was pronounced by the Supreme Court is very much to be taken into consideration by Honorable Minister and the government. Because this judgment having 113 pages, Justice Ramakrishna, he has given a clear judgment. I will just read one paragraph alone, which will give, because he has cited all the incidents throughout the world, what is happening in this particular issue. And he finally comes to the conclusion that you have to come forward. It is a two benches judgment. They give concurrent judgments, and they provide that there should be a domestic legislation should also come forward to protect these people. And I will just read how they look at the issue under Article 14 and transgenders. I quote paragraph 54. Article 14 of the Constitution of India states that the state shall not deny to any person equality before the law or equal protection of the laws within the territory of India. Equality includes the full and equal enjoyment of all rights and freedom. Right to equality has been declared as a basic feature of the Constitution. Treatment of equals as unequals or unequals as equals will be violative of the basic structure of the Constitution. In that way, it has got a lot of justification. And finally, the judgment says that the state has got certain obligation to come forward with the legislation. This work is done by our Honorable Member, Mr. Shiva, here. Beyond all the political things, I have to say that Tamil Nadu is, many of the social aspects, they are the pioneers. And more so, we feel that present government and also the earlier government run by 2006 itself, Dr. Kalinger has made the recognition of this particular gender as a third gender. In Tamil, they call it as a Thirunangai. That was the word coined by him. And they were given all the facilities, and the board was also constituted. I hope this was the inspiration on which Mr. Shiva has brought this bill also. And subsequently, the present government is also giving a lot of initiative for this purpose. But when one of our friends were citing the gay, we should not confuse ourselves with the transgender and the gay. Transgender is totally a recognition of a particular type of people who are not committed any sin, who are not committed any violation of the civilized system and other things. It is only a change in anatomy. When they were born, they were having certain type of anatomy. That is the only thing. They could not procreate. They cannot bring forth the children. They cannot be the cause of the bringing the children. That is the only thing. But there are many other incidents also happening that by proper way of surgery, the procedurally, they can also bring forth the children. Therefore, there is a happening is also coming up. The science is so much motivated now. Therefore, we feel that gay is totally a new method of having a single judge, a single sex to live together. That we cannot fully accept it. There may be a controversy in that discussion. And I feel that we should not mix both the things. This is a purely a matter which was civilization has accepted it as a part of that third gender. But in the second, that is the 19th century and 20th century part, we neglected that cultural aspect. We the Indians have protected the third gender. Now we have to rehabilitate them. How to rehabilitate them? How to protect their rights? How to bring them into the mainstream? How to make them also potential persons for the development of the society, to development of the nation? How they should sit along with us equal without any mockery or any stigma? That is the way this bill is drafted. I feel it is giving a life to them by way of statutory support. It is not a grace which we are doing it. It is not a as if a charity we are doing it, but we are recognizing a right which is for them, which is given by centuries by our Indian society, our Indian civilization, which has to be protected by way of domestic law. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Natchiappanji. Professor M. V. Rajeev Gowda.
Thank you, Vice Chairman, sir. I must congratulate Tiruchi Shiva for proposing this bill. It has a very inclusive definition of transgender persons, covers a broad spectrum, and an excellent definition of discrimination, which includes provisions for reasonable accommodation. Sir, many of the speakers below, before me, have already talked about how ancient Indian culture has always been very inclusive when it comes to accommodating and understanding the needs and the rights of transgenders. We've talked about Shikhandi, we've talked about Rihannalla, we've talked about Mohini. My own house god is Belur Chennakeshava, who is Krishna dressed in a woman's clothes. So there has always been a certain tolerance and a willingness to be inclusive in our ancient culture. That spirit must be incorporated in the way we run our country today. So that has not necessarily happened historically in the last few decades or even today, and we must do much more. So here, I would like to point out that the government of India has had to respond to a very historic judgment of the Supreme Court in the National Legal Services Authority case. In this context, the government has only filed a clarification petition. This is delaying the resolution of this legal process, and that way it does not provide for speedy justice to this vulnerable, stigmatized minority. So, while Tiruchi Shiva has done an extraordinary job in drafting this bill, I do think that it needs certain changes to bring it in compliance with the principles, you know, enunciated in the NALSA judgment, in the report of the Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment's Expert Committee on issues relating to transgender persons, and also with the Verma Committee report on amendments to the criminal law related to sexual violence. Let me just enumerate these as quickly as I can. First, sir, in terms of recognition of legal identity, the guiding principle of the NALSA judgment is legal recognition of gender identity, male, female, or third gender, based on self-identification amongst people. There is a legal procedure that has been proposed that includes a report which involves the district screening committee and a self-declared affidavit. So I recommend that this bill provide a separate section to affirmatively recognize the right to legal recognition, along with providing the procedure for the same. Sir, Tiruchi Shivaji has used the term transgender children. So this is a tricky term, because children are, until they become adolescents, are not necessarily fully aware of their identity, and therefore it is better to use a term that could be called gender non-conforming children, along with the term transgender children. And I recommend that children should be brought under the purview of this bill who are not only seen to be non-conforming, but are also perceived to be individuals who are non-conforming by others. This is a very tricky matter, and so I would suggest that the bill include the term transgender children, gender non-conforming children, children perceived to be transgender or gender non-conforming. Seems a little complicated, but that's more appropriate for children. So I would also urge Tiruchi Shiva to expand the education chapter to provide for inclusive education and adult education programs. He already does that, but the basic challenge faced by transgender children is harassment, discrimination, and bullying. That is something that we need to change by sensitizing teachers, sensitizing students. Already we have laws against ragging, but this is something that makes, you know, a real challenge for most vulnerable minorities. So for this group, we should not only have the establishment of anti-ragging, anti-bullying, anti-harassment cells, anti-discrimination cells, but this should be sensitized in education right from early childhood to later, and should also be sensitized and incorporated in teachers' training as well. So, I have one disagreement with the bill. Shivaji suggests that we should have a separate, exclusive transgender rights court. I think that it is more important for the mainstream legal system to be sensitive, to incorporate matters associated with transgender persons, and to deal with it in the same manner as anybody else would be dealt with. And so, in that existing framework, okay, he's put that also. Okay, very good then. All right. So, in terms of freedom of speech and expression of transgender community, this is again an interesting issue. So, freedom of speech under Article 19 You know, this bill also recognizes the right for the transgender community, but there are certain crucial components that were elaborated by the Supreme Court in the NALSA judgment. The court read the right to freedom of speech and expression under Article 19(1)(a) to include the right to expression of one's self-identified gender. Self-identified gender can be expressed through dress, words, action, or behavior, or any other form. A transgender's personality, the court notes, could be expressed by the individual's behavior and presentation. The state cannot prohibit, restrict, or interfere with the transgender's expression of such personality, subject to restrictions. I need 2 more minutes, sir. I'm finishing, don't worry. It's an important issue. And so bring this into the purview of the law. So going beyond the bill, there are 2 major issues. One is providing for adequate protection against sexual violence. So under Section 375, we do not take into account sexual violence against transgender communities. I recommend that Section 375 of the IPC be amended to make it gender neutral with respect to the victim, as recommended by the Justice Verma Commission. This should ensure that even if the assaulter is male, the victim should be any gender should fall under the purview of this bill. Then, most importantly, sir, we need to repeal Section 377 of the Indian Penal Code. I think the Minister for Social Justice and Empowerment could be a path-breaking figure if he goes ahead and pushes for the repeal of this very, very regressive section of the Indian Penal Code. So, in the NAS Foundation judgment, we know that Section 377 continues to have a deleterious impact on the lesbian, gay, bisexual, and transgender persons, and this must be repealed as quickly as possible. So, once that is done, we will see that 377 will not be used as a tool of abuse against transgender persons. And if we can get rid of this particular clause, we will be doing justice to not just transgenders, but to numerous people whose choice of sexual expression, choice of sexual preference is different from the mainstream. So the Union of India has a grave constitutional responsibility in this regard. It is up to the current government. As the minister has seen today, across party lines, we have support for this. This is an example of a law that can be brought in because it has the support of everyone. Every one of us agrees that if we want to achieve those glorious goals of the preamble of our constitution, to ensure equality of status and of opportunity, to ensure social justice, economic justice, and political justice, we cannot let the rights of transgenders be transgressed in any way. I urge the minister to take forward the extraordinary work done by Sri Tiruchi Shiva and to turn this bill into an official act. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Sri Kashya. Take only 3 to 4 minutes.
As you like it.
Okay, boliye boli. As you like it is a drama by Shakespeare.
Yes. Tiruchi Shivaji ke इस विधेयक के समर्थन में खड़ा हुआ हूं और जिन माननीय सदस्यों ने इस विधेयक के समर्थन में बहुत ही सकारात्मक सुझाव रखे हैं, मैं उनके साथ अपने आप को संबद्ध करते हुए कुछ 1-2 महत्वपूर्ण बातें करके समय का ध्यान रखते हुए अपनी बात को विराम दूंगा। चूंकि बिल में विपरीत लिंग व्यक्तियों के अधिकारों की बात को उभारा गया है, नॉर्थ इंडिया में खास तौर से इस समुदाय को लोग हिजड़े या किन्नर के नाम से पुकारते, तो मैं उसी नाम का संबोधन करूंगा ताकि वो लोग समझ सके कि वो किसकी बात कौन कर रहा है। और हमारे देश की बहुत सारी अच्छाइयां ऐसी हैं जिनको पूरी दुनिया में सराहा जाता है, हमारे देश की संस्कृति को, हमारे देश की सभ्यता को, हमारे देश की डेमोक्रेसी को, हमारे देश में रहने वाले तमाम धर्म मजहब के लोगों की एकता को, यूनिटी को। दुनिया के लोग भारत की व्यवस्था को, भारत की सभ्यता को उदाहरण के तौर पर प्रस्तुत करते हैं। ये हमारे देश की एक विशेष काबिलियत के रूप में दुनिया के अंदर देखी जाती है। लेकिन भारतीय समाज का ताना बाना जब उस पे कभी गंभीरता से चिंतन मनन करने का अवसर मिलता है तो बहुत सारी कमियां ऐसी निकल आती हैं जिनको देखकर कई बार तकलीफ भी होती है, दुख भी होता है। देश एक है, समाज एक है, सब हम लोग एक हैं, लेकिन एक समूह, एक वर्ग जो पैदा हुआ और पैदा होने के बाद उसके परिवार के लोग अगर ये समझें कि ये किन्नर है, ये हिजड़ा है, तो उसकी घर से विदाई बिना बैंड बाजे के हो जाती है। बेटी को विदा करें तो बारात आएगी, बैंड बजेगा, दावत होगी, बेटा पैदा हो जा, दावत होगी, तमाम खुशियां और तमाम चीजें होंगी। लेकिन जिस घर में किन्नर या हिजड़ा पैदा हो जाए, उस घर के लोग ही उससे मुंह फेर लेते हैं कि समाज में हम क्या मुंह दिखाएंगे, हमारे घर में कौन पैदा हुआ है। उपसभापति महोदय, ये सामाजिक भेदभाव, ये सामाजिक असमानता, ये सामाजिक गैर बराबरी, जिसको दूर करने के लिए शिवाजी ने एक कानून की शक्ल में एक प्राइवेट मेंबर बिल के तौर पर इस सदन में अपनी बात उपस्थित की है, और भारत की संसद की परंपरा कुछ इस तरह से रही है कि प्राइवेट मेंबर बिल को एक रसम अदायगी का एक जरिया मान के भाषण हो जाता है, मंत्री साहब का जवाब आ जाएगा, अनुरोध हो जाएगा, वापस ले लीजिए, हम विचार करेंगे, और बात समाप्त हो जाती है। उपसभापति महोदय क्षमा करेंगे, मुझे 12 वर्ष उत्तर प्रदेश की विधान परिषद में बैठने का मौका मिला, और उस परिषद के सभापति जी के अधिकार और उनके दायित्व, उनके कर्तव्य को जानने का मौका मिला। बहुत सारे फैसले पीठ से ऐसे होते हैं, सरकार चाहे या ना चाहे, लेकिन कोई विधेयक, कोई कानून, कोई बात अगर समाज के हित में है तो पीठ से उन पर निर्णय करने की पूरा अधिकार पीठ के पास रहता है। मैं ये अनुरोध करना चाहता हूं, मैं अनुरोध करना चाहता हूं उपसभापति महोदय कि कम से कम इस विधेयक पर हम रसम अदायगी के थोड़ा उससे आगे चले, इस बिल को हम कानून की शक्ल दें, इस बिल को हम कानूनी बिल स्वीकार करें, ताकि संसद पे भी दुनिया का लोगों का भरोसा बढ़े। और ये पहला ऐसा अवसर नहीं है, कोई ये पहला ऐसा विषय नहीं है कि किसी समूह के साथ इनजस्टिस हुआ है, किसी समूह के साथ भेदभाव हुआ है। महोदय, हमारे देश और देश के तमाम लोग इस बात को जानते हैं, इस बात को समझते हैं कि देश के आजाद होने के पहले हमारे देश की सामाजिक व्यवस्था में इतनी खामियां थी, इतनी दिक्कतें थी, इवन टू क्षमा करें कि दलितों को, आदिवासियों को, कमजोरों को, गरीबों को, वंचितों को, शोषितों को, पिछड़ों को सामाजिक ताने बाने में साथ बैठकर चलने का अधिकार नहीं था, साथ बैठकर खाने का अधिकार नहीं था। अभी उत्तर प्रदेश में घटना हो गई, एक दलित ने किसी के साथ बैठ के खाना खा लिया, उसकी नाक काट ली, उसकी नाक इसलिए काट ली कि वो दलित था। ऐसी व्यवस्था भारतीय समाज में अगर ऐसी व्यवस्था कायम रहेगी तो सामाजिक ताना बाना कहीं ना कहीं कमजोर होगा। मैं अपील करूंगा यस, मैं एंड कर रहा हूं, प्लीज मैं एंड करता हूं, इस बिल का समर्थन करता हूं।
केस पुलिस केस नहीं फाइल हो गया, आपने बोला हम नाक काट कर दिया।
केस होने से समाज की प्रतिष्ठा वापस नहीं आ सकती है, समाज का सम्मान वापस नहीं आ सकता। आई एम
आस्किंग,
जो एक विजन लोगों का बन जाता है किसी समूह के खिलाफ, किसी वर्ग के खिलाफ, उस विजन को खत्म करने के लिए सख्त कानून की जरूरत है। इसलिए मैं भारतीय समाज में हिजड़ों और किन्नरों को भी बराबर सामाजिक, राजनीतिक और संवैधानिक अधिकार प्राप्त हों, इस संदर्भ में आदरणीय मंत्री जी बहुत सूझवान हैं, बहुत दर्द तकलीफ पर उस समूह से संबंध रखते हैं जिसके साथ ये सारी चीजें होती हैं। मेरा अनुरोध है कि इस विधेयक को सरकारी विधेयक के तौर पर स्वीकार करके सदन में इतिहास बनाए कि ये संसद देश के किन्नर और हिजड़ों के लिए भी कानून बना के उनके अधिकारों को प्रोटेक्ट कर सकती है। आपने धन्यवाद, आपने अवसर दिया, बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
लेकिन मेरा सुझाव है, सुनो, यू मेंशनड एन इंसिडेंट हियर, आप जो नरेट कर दिया, इट इज वेरी सीरियस, यू शुड एंश्योर व्हेदर केस इज रजिस्टर्ड एंड स्ट्रॉन्ग एक्शन पनिशमेंट दैट पर्सन शुड गेट हु हैज कट द नोज ऑफ ए दलित, दैट इज व्हाट यू सेड फॉर ईटिंग टुगेदर, दैट इज वेरी सीरियस, इफ इट हैपेंड इन दिस कंट्री यू शुड टेक इट अप, इट इज नॉट इनफ दैट यू स्पीक हियर,
यस
यू गो इंक्वायर एंड इफ नो एक्शन इज टेकन यू शुड टेक इट अप वेरी सीरियसली. You can raise yes. that your incident even here. It is an atrocity on a Harijan, on a scheduled caste.
Schedule
you can bring the list. You can raise it here.
Harijan is not the proper, sir.
Oh, yeah, I know. Yes. Please, sir. I withdraw that word and explain. I agree. Dalit. Yes.
Yes.
So do that. Take it up that. It is not enough that you mention it here. Okay?
72 Parliament mein 14 प्राइवेट मेंबर्स बिल और रिजोल्यूशन पास हुए हैं, लोकसभा में यहां 9 और वहां 5, इतिहास बना हुआ है. 72 के बाद से हॉल्ट हो गया कि प्राइवेट मेंबर्स रिजोल्यूशन में देखते हैं सोचते हैं रुक जाता है, तो फिर एक इतिहास शुरू करा दीजिए मंत्री जी.
आई सेड समथिंग एल्स,
इतिहास शुरू कराइए, इतिहास हॉल्ट हो गया है. इसी हाउस में 9 प्राइवेट मेंबर्स बिल पास हुए हैं. निशाद जी,
सिर्फ 2-3 मिनट्स हैं. ओके,
उपसभापति महोदय, विपरीत लिंग व्यक्तियों के अधिकार विधेयक 2014 हमारे माननीय सदस्य शिवाजी ने प्रस्तुत किया है, मैं उसमें समर्थन के लिए खड़ा हुआ हूँ. महोदय, जितने भी हमारे माननीय सदस्यों ने इसमें विचार रखे, मैं अपने को संबद्ध करता हूँ. किन्नर हिजड़ा, महोदय, ये प्रकृति द्वारा उनके साथ अन्याय होता है, फिर समाज द्वारा अन्याय किया जाता है. शिक्षा से लगा करके उनको समाज में रहने का अधिकार नहीं दिया जाता है, इसलिए ये बिल लाया गया है. ये बहुत अच्छा है. हम देखते हैं कि महिला किन्नर भी हैं, पुरुष किन्नर भी हैं, जिनके साथ भेदभाव होता है. कई माननीय सदस्यों ने जिक्र किया, हॉस्पिटल में पुरुष वार्ड महिला वार्ड हैं, अब वहाँ समस्या आती है किस वार्ड में इनको रखा जाए. इसी तरह शौचालय की भी बात आई, और जेल में भी दो ही वार्ड होते हैं, एक पुरुष वार्ड एक महिला वार्ड, उनको तन्हाई में फिर अलग से तन्हाई में रखा जाता है. तो ये समस्या है. संख्या बताई गई कि 4.9 लाख, निर्वाचन आयोग ने कहा 23,841. महोदय, शादी विवाह बच्चों के पैदा के समय होने वाले उत्सव में आशीर्वाद देने व गाने बजाने के लिए देखे जाते हैं, या रेड लाइट पे देखेंगे तो हर जगह मिल जाएंगे. महोदय, एक हम लोगों ने जो पढ़ा है सुना है, हमेशा वो ताली बजाते रहते हैं, और उससे एक थेरेपी के तहत तो अक्वा पंचर की एक उनके वह इनको नहीं देखा गया किसी हॉस्पिटल में. ताली बजाने से वो कभी बीमार नहीं होते किसी हॉस्पिटल में. किसी ने, हमने तो नहीं देखा, और आप लोगों ने किसी ने देखा हो तो मैं नहीं जानता हूँ, लेकिन अक्वा पेशर ताली बजाने से उनके वो बीमारी नहीं होती. एक एक समाज के लिए संदेश भी है, कोई कीर्तन भजन करता है तो ताली बजाए तो उससे भी उसको लाभ होता है, तो उसका एक संदेश जाता है. महोदय, और हम बताना चाहेंगे, हमारे माननीय मंत्रीगण, एक हमारे केंद्रीय मंत्री हैं, पशुओं के लिए संरक्षण के लिए बड़ी लड़ाई पूरे देश में लड़ती हैं. हमारे माननीय सामाजिक न्याय अधिकारिता मंत्री हैं, हम इनसे निवेदन करना चाहेंगे कि जब पशुओं के लिए लड़ाई लड़ी जा सकती है तो क्या इंसान के लिए लड़ाई नहीं लड़ी जा सकती? वो तो इंसान है. तो हम आपसे विनती करना चाहते हैं, अनुरोध करना चाहते हैं, इसमें जो माननीय हमारे सदस्यों ने अपना अपना वक्तव्य दिया है उसको जोड़ने का काम करें. महोदय, और भी तमाम दिक्कतें हैं, जैसे कि जब हमारा देश आज़ाद हुआ, आज़ादी के पहले से लगा करके आदिवासी और हमें हमारे नरेंद्र जी कह रहे थे दलित और पिछड़ों के साथ जो है भेदभाव किया जाता था, उनको शिक्षा के अधिकार से वंचित कर दिया गया था। जो पुरोहित लोग थे, जब बच्चा पैदा होता था तो उनको अगर नाम पूछने जाते थे, अगर शेड्यूल कास्ट का है, बैकवर्ड का है, आदिवासी है, तो पुरोहित लोग कहते थे कि क्या नाम का है, लुच्चा नाम रखा दो, लफंगा नाम रखा दो, खचेड़ू रखा दो, घुरहू रखा दो, चैतुआ, बैसखुआ, जेठुआ, जेठ पैदुआ, जेठुआ रखा दो। तो जब बच्चा स्कूल में जाता था, हाजिरी भरी जाती थी, अगर मास्टर कहता था खचेड़ू, लुच्चा, लफंगा, सारे कक्षा के बच्चे हंसते थे, वो एक आध महीना, एक दो महीना में ही क्लास छोड़ करके, शिक्षा छोड़ कर चला जाता था। उसी तरह से आज ये आज हमारे इनके किन्नरों के साथ हो रहा है। हमें महाभारत का भी एक उदाहरण याद है, जब वीर एकलव्य शिक्षा लेने के लिए द्रोणाचार्य जी के पास गए तो केवल वो शूद्र थे, इसलिए उनको शिक्षा से वंचित कर दिया गया कि तुमको धनुर्विद्या नहीं सिखाई जा सकती। तो मानवर ये इनके लिए जब सुप्रीम कोर्ट, हाई कोर्ट, सारे न्यायालय कह रहे हैं
please,
इनके साथ भेदभाव बंद किया please, जाना चाहिए। और जो हमारे माननीय सदस्य बिल लाए हैं, मैं उनका समर्थन करता हूँ और उम्मीद करता हूँ माननीय मंत्री जी से, पूरा सदन सहमत है, ये बहुत अच्छा बिल है, इसको सरकारी बिल बनाकर बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।
ओके, that I think it's over. Viplove ji, your party has no time left. Your party has no time left.
4 minutes.
2 minutes. Okay. 2 minutes.
मैं बहुत आभारी हूँ शिवाजी का कि जो ये बिल लेके आए हैं और इसमें इनकी जो भावना है बहुत ठीक है। मैं सिर्फ इतना कहना चाहती हूँ कि ये चाहे हम हिजड़ा कहें, चाहे किन्नर कहें, चाहे ट्रांसजेंडर करें, इनका जो ट्रॉमा है इन्हीं का नहीं, इनके जो माँ बाप का ट्रॉमा है वो भी एक सोचने की बात है। जब माँ बाप को पता लगता है कि हमारा बच्चा हिजड़ा है या ट्रांसजेंडर में है और उनसे जब कम्युनिटी वाले लेने आते हैं, उस समय जो उनका हाल होता है वो एक देखने की बात होती है। किस तरह से माँ अपने बच्चे को अलग करने के लिए मजबूर हो जाती है। इसलिए मैं ये कहूंगी कि जो इन्होंने बिल लाया बहुत ठीक लाया है। इसमें हमारे जो मंत्री जी से कहूंगी कि आप इसका समर्थन कीजिए और इसमें बच्चों की पढ़ाई के लिए उनके लिए एक स्पेशल कीजिए, उनको स्पेशल स्कूल दीजिए जिससे वो पढ़ लिख के अपने पैरों पे खड़े हो सके, उनको घर घर जाके एक तरह से नाचना या गाना ना पड़े। ये कोई उनका कसूर नहीं है, ये एक बायोलॉजिकल जो है सबसे बड़ी घटना है जिसके लिए वो मजबूर हो जाते हैं। तो इसलिए मैं ये कहना चाहूंगी कि इसके ऊपर गंभीरता से सोचा जाए, उनको मेन स्ट्रीम में लाया जाइए। ये केवल माँ बाप का भी ट्रॉमा है, उनका भी ट्रॉमा है, उनका भी दुख है। मैं जानती हूँ कि किस तरह एक माँ अपने बच्चे को अपने से अलग करती है, उसके लिए तो वो बच्चा ही है, चाहे वो ट्रांसजेंडर है, चाहे वो है। पहले राजे महाराजों के यहाँ जो हमारे महिलाओं के वो महल होते थे उनमें इनको रखा जाता था, एक तरह से ये करके कि ये हमारा स्पाइंग का काम करेंगे, इनसे कोई हार्म नहीं है। लेकिन हमें इस प्रवृत्ति से, जहाँ पे हम महिला सशक्तिकरण की बात करते हैं वहाँ इनकी सशक्तिकरण की बात भी करनी चाहिए, ये भी हमारे एक समाज का अंग है। तो मैं इसलिए मैं बधाई देती हूँ शिवाजी को कि ये बिल लाए हैं और मंत्री जी से अनुरोध करती हूँ कि इसको जिस तरह से सभी ने कहा है प्राइवेट मेंबर बिल दे के वापस मत लीजिए, इसको सरकारी दस्तावेज बनाइए और इसके लिए बहुत गंभीरता से सोचिए। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद।